Hey everyone, it's Dave, Displayfireworks1. We're less than a week from the July 4th holiday. I'm here at F&V Fireworks, located right at the border of Pennsylvania and Ohio. Here's their shirt. This is, you may remember I was here last year. They sell some of my product here too. We're gonna see if we can find it. What's cool about this place is it's a, like, quote, mom and pop type of fireworks store, all different kind of brands in here. And he has a salvage yard, AKA junkyard of cars he runs here. So it's part of a business. He's been at it a while. It's kind of tight in there and there's a lot of customers here. So we're gonna go through and see what he has. But he wants me to emphasize he still has a lot of products available. If you're interested in coming, you could look it up, F&V Fireworks. All right, we're gonna go inside, take a quick look, see what's going on. When we're inside, we're gonna go through, try to stay out of the customer's way as much as we can. Here, he starts out here if you wanna get an assortment. I think he puts these together himself. Let's move up while there's no one here.
Even putting it up there is a good help, thank you.
There's, as a user of fireworks, there's advantages to stores that have multiple brands. There really is, because you could just see there's all sorts of collections of different brands here. Oh, we see our friend Rob has his stuff here.
Thank you, man.
Raccoon. Cutting Edge. A lot of these stores are having trouble getting product in this year, that's for sure. And here we got Dominator 500 gram cakes here. Oh, this is something different. A million fireflies. Oh, I'd like to look at that one. See, I don't even know. Or is it just Saturn battery? Remove cover before you shoot it. Okay, here, let's move over to the side here, let these customers come through. Some Magnus. You can see some of the brands. We're here on a Sunday, and it's still, it's busy. Most of these fireworks stores are going to be open all the way till 9 o'clock at night. And I think he is too. He also has a second store off of the turnpike too. We're going to see maybe if we have enough time to check that one out too. Oh, look at all the different brands here. Always nice, you know? Yeah. Looks like you picked this dude up on hitchhiking on a dark road, huh? Here's the honey badger, always a great cake. World class stuff. See, they try to play on some of that things on TV or whatever, throne games. Don't say Game of Thrones. Okay, that's not us. It's throne games, okay? It's close. But we don't have to pay anybody with that. You know what? I don't know whether this ever caught on, like part of a picture here, part of a picture there. Some kind of boom stuff. Eventually find my stuff in here somewhere. Here, let's get some stuff here. Kind of squeeze around the customers. Rum soaked pineapple. You know, what's funny is you can overhear people like planning their shows a little bit. Kind of fun. Okay, we're gonna try to squeeze through here.
Excuse me. All right, thank you, sir.
Some of these people, I recognize their brands' names from Facebook. Pablo Diablo. You won't run over here while no one's here. These are going to get tougher to find, some of these bigger tube shells, which world class. I know a lot of these companies now, and it'll be curious to see if it's even worth it. They'll decorate the outside of the box instead of just a generic cardboard box. I guess more to encourage like case sales or whatever. Here's the one everybody's crazy over right here. Wacky tobacco. This is the last time I saw this was at the NFA, I think, the last time I went. So this will be probably more of a collector's piece than anything. I don't even know who made that. But they, trying to capitalize on it, I guess. Wild Dragon brand still around. Legend. You can see, like right here, these gender reveal. There were, last year, everything was so popular last year that people, one fireworks store told me they were just buying gender reveal just to have something to light. And some places were sweeping parts of the warehouse they never swept. So it was a big year. Okay, here's everyone's favorite, artillery shells. It's number one in the world. And if you don't believe me, call them up and ask them, okay? Here's the new one everybody was wanting pretty. The new ones. I got some of these coming in the Display Fireworks 1 category, my brand. But it won't be here until late August, I think. And the combination cake I'm selling too. There's my cake right there. Backyard Battlefield. Hey, you're good. That's okay. Excuse us. Right here. Now remember, my cakes have the port if you have a firing system. Connect right into it. Okay, here, I see another one here. You know what? This cake is completely sold out at the distributor. And what's funny, when I came in, I could have swore I saw Storm Surge right here, and now it's gone. I just found out yesterday Storm Surge is sold out at the distributor. So if you're going to find it anywhere, it's going to be on the retail store. At go to my website. You could a link of everyone selling. Oh, you got more?
I'll bring some.
Yeah, one of the workers just whispered he has some more. But there was one here, and now it's gone. What's a good sign? Bring a bunch in. Here's my firecracker. Where's Black Cat at? How come we ain't got Black Cat firecrackers in here? Maybe I'll be the new Black Cat. They're the best you can get, too. You could ask them. They used to be here somewhere.
Exactly. Anyway. That's the goal.
No Black Cat. The whole kind of place is this, right? No Black Cat firecracker. These have been around for years. These. Here you go. Here we stop it. Whew, I was worried. Thanks.
Why were you worried?
I'm just messing with you. This one has the portrait. This is my new artwork. And we did it. If you bought it last year, it's my new artwork. And my artist, I draw all of this, and he makes it, I'll sketch it. He threw this cobra in here without me knowing. And I said, what a nice touch, you know. So I'm subtly trying to get everybody into this electrical sign.
It's the one, honey.
We're trying to stay out of people's way a little bit. We're over here, some of the artillery shells. There's some brands here.
Hi guys.
Showgun kits.
Good, how are you? Good. You smell?
Oh, I'm just looking.
Okay. This could be fun. If you have tight clearance, you know. Lots of brands. You're seeing, over the years I'm finding when you shoot these canister artillery shells, you really need a little more extra clearance than you think because of that clay that it's made of, as opposed to something like this that's all cardboard, you know. So keep that in mind, play it safe. This looks like some old stock stuff over here, time bomb.
Should have tried to figure it out.
Let's try and walk over to the next stop. Now, I don't know why, but when I see this, I think my friend Carson and Boom Wild. So let's see if it's got that Carson Boom Wild look to it. Can't tell. Let me do a Carson Boom Wild imitation. Hey! He kills me in some of those videos. Oh, look, comb found. Ooh, that got a little weight to it. You know. So that's looking feeling pretty good. Yeah. I want to make a fountain, you know, big fountain. Problem is you can only put so much in one tube or mortar, you know, when you make it. So I like a totally quiet fountain to go out at night and just shoot something and get your fix. Take your time. Let's go over by the Roman candles. Lots of Roman candles. You know, when I first started, trying to do something that wasn't real expensive and experiment with electrical firing years back, I would just buy these and fuse them up and, fuse across here and, impress someone in my little displays with something fun. I like Roman candles. I'm kind of envious in a way. There was a video on Facebook from one of the China manufacturers, big 80-shot Roman candle. And, we're limited. We can't make them that big in the United States. And it was, I said, boy, I don't know why. I love those Roman candles. They're just a bunch of shots. So we can get them here, but they're all jammed like in separate mortars, separate tubes. Rockets, always be, you know, be careful where you're shooting. You know, you got limited clearance. You know, and going, you know, people say, I'm like, phew, you know. Single shot items, you know, a little more costly but convenient. Here's some more gender reveal. There was like too much gender reveal at one time. But see, if you make this gender reveal, you can't. This is like, hey, what's the secret going to be, right? You know what it is already. You got to have a code. I think it was Winda was one of the first to just have like a question mark thing and a code that only you knew what it colored. You know, because hey, we. Hey, everybody shoot one, and then we're going to guess what it is. There you can see, right? Yeah. This stuff here, it's just like borderline offensive to me. I don't know why, but somebody must have. Mm-hmm.
6 in there, or 1 inch.
A lot of sparks here. Yeah. Here's some here.
That's a 1 inch penis right there. Yeah.
Years back, there was, if I remember the history right, there was a tariff on sparklers, but the metal rod ones, you know, to protect the last manufacturer of sparklers in the United States. And I think the last manufacturer now is Phantom. They actually have the equipment. I covered that in one of my videos. So this is where all these wooden rod ones start coming about. And supposedly there's new ones out now that are safer and you won't get burned. This one. Well, he got a ton of rockets in there. Cheap fun, you know. You're a kid, man. You could just play with that kind of stuff all day. Shooting. For not a lot of money. Okay, we're coming to the end. Here's a little bit of stuff here. F&V Fireworks is at Enon Valley, Pennsylvania, right on the border of Pennsylvania and Ohio. See, so now it's, what's funny is there's a prism store down at the intersection. The prism store was trying to get the Pennsylvania people that crossed right on that border. This is what they used to do. But now everything's legal in Pennsylvania. So there's three cars at the prison parking lot. And I asked somebody, that's probably the employees, right? So everybody's here at F&V. So everything's legal in Pennsylvania. Come down, pick it up now. He's plenty stocked. All right, let's see if we have enough time to catch the other store. I'm on my way to the other store. You didn't believe me, there were three cars? Now there's only two. And the other guy went to lunch with me. So F&V's packed. There's only two cars there. This is how the law changes who goes where to shop. This road I'm on is the border between Pennsylvania and Ohio. And if you look, F&V has a sign. I don't know if I can get that close to it. It has a sign right here, kind of diverting from the other store. So that's going to, the change in the Pennsylvania fireworks law changed the dynamics of prism fireworks at that location. Everyone, it's Dave again. We're at the second F&B location. Now, it's a good time to be here. The rush that was here is gone. There's a little gap, so we're going to try to cover as much as we can going through the store. Of course, you know, I like this store because they highlight all my products here. I know last year they had a bunch of them here. So, here you go. I'll tell you what's sold out at the distributor in Ohio. So it's all on a retail shelf somewhere. Okay, these are still around, my firecrackers. This cake, completely sold out. at the distributor. So it's all on a retail shelf somewhere. Yesterday, this one sold out. It's on a retail shelf. You can see, here's my new artwork. Again, this one's still available. Backyard Battlefield. Remember, they all have the ports. Willow Beach, completely sold out. Okay, there's more coming. This one is Recursion, not sold out yet. You know, so here it is here. And you know, always, as you can see, I got reference with the Cobra here and a couple of these. This artwork is one of my older original artists. This is some of this stuff here, my newer artist. And this one here, if you look, there's a story I have with it. It has pictures of my daughter with some of her costumes playing her cosplay role. It kind of fit in with the artwork. Okay, let's go through the store. And guess what? They still have some Pyro Daves here. He said he sold about four of them the other day. People coming in for them. So I think they may have bought the last of them from World Class. You know, so we'll see. All right. I kind of like the way this store is set up. You know, when you come in, you get some of the smaller items here, you know, firecrackers. You know, usually most of these places start like this, firecrackers, and here are the smaller items. This, I don't know if the same company makes it. That paper on here, they used to make a 20-ball candle. I used to just love it. It was so affordable and fun. And this one is too. I mean, it's not real expensive. But like I said, if you're new and don't have a lot of money, you can do fun stuff. Create and do whatever with this. Okay. Rock is all, man. He must have bought a ton of these Roman candles. They're like everywhere in both stores. Different brands here too. Let's just grab one here. World Class. Sparklers. I don't know if it's metal or whatever. These, you know what I always hate with these? If you give a girl a sparkler, you know, boys will be like, girls are like, you know, they just got to do all kinds of, but this is not one you want to do that with. Okay? Yeah. I wouldn't recommend you do it at all, but it's just, you know, all through my life, it's like, you know, my parents are like, hold that sparkler, yeah, whatever, and then the neighborhood girls come over and they're doing their little pom-pom shows with them and stuff. Brothers. Window. I'm sure there's something that does, I just don't know why. This one's been around, Dominator. This one here. Okay. This has been around too. Must still be popular. All the fountains. Moving into some of the bigger cakes. Cutting Edge. Fisherman. Oh, look at this. America's Greatest Fireworks. I don't know. This will tell you right away what it is, okay? This is Chinese fireworks, right here. These are fun. I don't know if a lot of people really know how to light them off, you know. If I remember right, even if you set it up wrong, it kind of puffs a little bit and makes it go upright. Almost thought that was fuse. Yeah. Fuse is tight and tough to get. This is that Roman candle I think I talked about at the other store. You know, put it in the ground, has a bunch in it. Okay. Party poppers. Chicken with balloon. Some of this stuff, you know, you can entertain the kids. Have a lot of fun. More 500 gram. Dragon blade. Demon. Diablo. Bipolar box. I like it. Changed since the last time I've been here. This is, here it is, honey badger again. I think they know they got a good cake with this one. Unicorn. Raccoon's pretty popular around. Pollination, this is a big one. I think this comes out of here, out of Boone. What's happening is a lot of stores are looking where they can get stuff because of the shortage, which is good because now you get the customer benefits from having multiple brands out. Oh, look, it's like an optical illusion, or what do they call it? I don't know, it's like 3D. I don't know if the camera can pick that up. It looks like it's sticking out. Pretty creative. This one, too, it shows. Looks like it's sticking out away from the package. Oh, this is, there's a story behind this and his daughter. And the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation. His daughter passed away at a young age. And this is the event he has that I cover in the hallway. So they didn't have it this year because of the virus restrictions. But this cake is in her honor. And the proceeds go to that organization. This. It's a good cake.
We need a jacket.
I shot it. The problem was I shot it once and loved it. I shot it again and thought it was bad, but it wasn't dark enough. You really have to wait till total darkness with this. And I recommend shooting more than one, but it really turned out great from my memory. See, you know, from 1 year to the next sometime, you don't know 100% with consumer. This is, I remember when this first came out, I did a video for a world class about it. Alright, let's stop in a minute and see if the other aisle's clear. Yeah, I'm trying to stay out of some of the customer's way, so we'll cover this section. The ones I have coming are going to be in a kit similar to this. The canister shelves. And I expect them to be in late August. And my combination kit. But I'm going to start with this type of a setup. This is a congested sector, these artillery shells. You can see there's just a bunch here. And there aren't too many bad ones that I'm seeing. This one is pretty good. Most of these are really good, to be honest. Okay, let's work our way down here. See them here. this one still keeps popping. But if I remember right, the owner may have bought the remaining ones from World Class on these. So it's still out and about, and decent cake, but you know, didn't meet the numbers it needed to meet. There it is. So we just keep moving on. All right, back to the back. Still around, big firecrackers. Here's some here. Might rolls up at the end. Probably should throw some over here. You know, talk to him about that. Being a competitive mix over here. Okay? All right, we got some black cats. Okay, we didn't have black cat at the other store. It's the best you can get. And if you don't believe me, call them and ask them. They'll tell you. All right. Racks if you need them. You know, but be sure if you buy a rack that it's the proper size. If it's a canister shell or a ball shell, they're different. All right, let's check this over. Looks clear. V-shape. So remember when you set it up, if you see a V. We got a few different brands. I don't know why I remember this label last time I toured this store. You know, it's just got a certain color that kind of sticks in my memory for some reason. Some of these look familiar from last time. Here's the Saturn batteries. I just wish they would speed them up a little bit. And I think some of them did change something. I talked about it before. I want to know what Fireflies are. Fireflies different than a Saturn missile. I don't know. So if someone knows, you know, about it, please tell me. This magnus is like everywhere. This is like the bar, like the bar of vodka. Like everywhere you go, it's like you got magnus. It's like every bar in town will have that. You know, exactly. Go to the airport. Hey, the vodka. Yeah, we got magnus. It's like bar stock. You know, it's everywhere. Okay. Cutting edge. I'm trying to find a different brand. Fisherman. Fisherman. You know, world class is that way too. In a way, it's kind of common everywhere. So there's you know, it's your stock. Your stock beverage or whatever. It's a brand out of Michigan, if I remember right. Angry White. Choke mug. Now, hey, I don't want to be sexist, but if that was the other way around, the husband choking the wife, I don't think that would go over too well, all right? Palm Paradise. Good name, Squealer. These cakes, I like these cakes. This size of a cake, it's good if you don't have a lot of clearance. And if you shoot a bunch of them, some of these have really surprising performance sometimes, that's for sure. These smaller cakes, 16, 20 shot, this sort of thing. Boomer, boomer, boomer. What else we got? Liberty Bell, cutting edge. Okay, let's try and make it over one more. I forgot where we left off. I was talking to a customer just, and he was looking for some advice. Now, he lives in a congested area in the city, and he has houses next to him in Pennsylvania. So I told him kind of what not to buy. And some of my cakes probably are not going to fit there. And I recommended like the 200 gram, 16 shot, stuff that goes straight up. I told them how to look at the shape of a cake. You know, if it's a V-shaped cake, he doesn't really want that. It'll shoot over to the neighbors, etc. So straight up and this sort of thing. He was waiting for his family to show up. These little things in tight clearances are good. This sort of thing. Festival, you know, the smaller ones. You know, so it's gave him some advice on it, you know. And hopefully he'll, something like this is good too. So it's just a little slip. And then I told him about stabilizing, you know. A lot of people don't know that, they're new. You know, put a brick or something next to it so it doesn't tip. So maybe I should work in a fireworks store, open one up, you know. Okay. Come over here, the smaller shells we were talking about. These again are, you know, convenient more than anything, a little expensive, you know, for a single shot sort of a thing, but some people like them. They don't, you know, I've no people that budget is open, and I'll just nail a bunch of these down on something and light them. What else here? Firecrackers, silver salutes, overused term. Silver salutes in a white too. You couldn't even make it silver. that's it. I'm going to have to tell them to get my firecrackers over here. I want to be in the mix, okay? I mean, I'm top row over there coming to the door, but, you know, I got to see what I can do about that. All right, everyone, that is the tour of both of F&V stores. I hope you enjoyed it. And that's it. We're coming up on the July 4th holiday. See you soon.